Live from the path. It's like playing hopscotch with Jimmy Durante.
I kind of looked at it as Jesus kind of dealing with my pride issues a little bit, because these are things that I would flippantly say, I'll do what I want. Seriously, yeah. I think this is a dumb law. But like the truth of it is, like, and I really should have looked the verse up, but it's like, you know, one of the qualifications to being an elder of church is to be above reproach, you know, in the eyes of man. And the man wrote the law, you know, like, and there's certain cultural laws, you know, like if they were to cross a line and say, you know, make abortion a legal act, that, you know, I in areas I have a problem with that, and that is against God's law. That is not something where I can move. That's not something where I can say that's acceptable.
That's where, yeah, we will obey God rather than man type.
Right, and so, but God didn't say, Jesus did not speak to the act of talking on your cell phone while driving. Our government tends to. And so, and I don't see anything against God's law that says that I should be able to talk on my cell phone while I'm driving. So the real crux of it is that I'm having a hard time handing that over to Jesus, saying, I don't want to pull over every time I get a call.
Well, in this case also, you're working for a company, so it's not really illegal by the law, but by your company policy.
Well, it's actually both.
But it's illegal by the law, too.
Now, okay. a standard issue driver, I believe, can still talk on his cell phone. I don't think they can roast you about that. You can't text.
I mean, that's the whole idea of submission, like in Ephesians 6, Ephesians 5:21, everyone submit to one another out of reverence to Christ. Mm. He gets in the husbands and wives and so forth. But it's also the government side there of saying, I'm putting myself under your authority. And so you would put yourself under the authority of our current government by living here. You know, you could live somewhere else, yep, in our society. Move to Canada, you know. Move to Cuba. They're lawless, you know.
Right.
Or
the also, lawless Cubans.
It sounded good. You've also put yourself under the
Gracias,
authority.
Gracias, Castro. I do what I mean.
Of your you know, employer at the moment. And mm-hmm. So you have two sides right there saying don't do it.
You know what the funny part is, though? Like, and you'll find this true with most employers. And I don't know that my employer's this way. I think they're a pretty straight-up company, right? But, like, most of that stuff is done with a wink and a smile. Like, oh, it's yeah. done with – I. Here's
To
what
cover themselves legally.
Here's what we're writing down to cover us, so in case there's trouble, yeah. You take the fall for this thing. But on the other hand, I expect the same amount of produce out of you, and here's what I'm going to expect. So if I got a phone call – you know, I tend to get a lot of phone calls during the day. So every time that I'm driving down the interstate at 70 – pull over, take the phone call, and get going again. That's going to add 45 minutes to an hour of my day. You know, and they'll say, "Yeah, that's absolutely what they want you to, what we want you to do. Yeah. That's what we want." You know, and then you know, 3 months later, you're gonna be like, "Listen, your productivity's down.
we're gonna let you go.
We really like, we want to know what's going on here." You know, so I, you know, and that seems to be, and I don't know if there's a lot of people that deal with this in the working world, but a lot of stuff is done. A lot of company policies are done with a wink and a smile. They're done with, here's how it's going to lay out, here's what we want from you. And if you follow that to the T, you're going to be the guy that produces less, because you're confined by rules that you're attempting to follow.
I don't know, but I think that that puts us in a difficult worldly position in what something that should otherwise be easy spiritual decision, right? I mean, the rules are the rules, the law is the law, I am submitting to the authority of this company. The question then becomes, if the authority of this company is the wink and the smile, right? It's not really leading someone and saying, here's the rule. They're saying, here's the rule. I don't care whether you do it or not. Or, I actually don't want you to do it, but we have to use it as our stated policy. You're beholden to what? The wink or the smile?
Well, that's the thing. You know, it's, and you know what? That's probably a topic that gets really hard for people in sales. You know, that's a topic that gets really hard for people in the financial industry. I mean, those things get to be... they get to be really wish-washy. You know, where's the line? What can I say? Your company policy is really restrictive, but you also know that like, especially people who are in like phone banks or people that are you're calling to sell things, and you have to leave, you know, the protocol is to leave a little bit of information out that you're not necessarily want to pump out. And if they, you know, the customer will ask you a direct question, they're like, here's the answer we want you to give them. And you're like, that's not the whole truth. That's like half the truth, because you still want them to buy what we're selling, you know? Mm-hmm. And so... some of that's an ethical, you know, decision that you have to try to jump. It's like, can I even work for these people, or do I just tell the truth and let them fire me? You know, yeah. Do I just say, look, the truth is the truth. Here's the deal. You know, here's what you want me to say, but I'm not going to lie on your behalf, even for your money, because now you're taking blood money. You know what I'm saying? You're a hired liar. They're paying you to tell lies to people. Yeah. You know, and a lot of people don't see it that way. They're like, well, it's just my job. And that's where the means equals the end. You know, with the Christ follower, the means are the whole thing. How you conducted yourself, how you lived your life, how you portrayed the truth and love of Jesus Christ to others with your actions. And if you're willing to portray that for $16.50 an hour, then maybe you say, well, I got to feed my family. Jesus said he'll take care of that. I clothe the lilies of the field. I feed the birds. You know what I'm saying? I will provide these things for you without you having to sell your integrity in me.
Right. The consequence is never that you have to violate my love or abandon my law and my direction for your life simply to do the basics of life that I said I would otherwise take care of.
Right. And yeah. And you know what? And the simple fact of the this truth really should reveal a lot to you about your past life. Like, look at your past life and look at the things that you compromised for your job, or you compromised for a social situation, you know, to make a buddy, or to, you know, just make something easier that day. And realize all the times that you tied God's hands. God gave you the right direction and told you how to do it, and this is how I want you to live. And you're like, well, there's no way that the Lord expected me not to make more money.
You know, and actually, so I think that, for the most part, describes the biggest issue that people can look at Christianity as a hypocritical religion. Because people are constantly ceding ground. No one's willing to stand on principle. No one's willing to, like, we're willing to give up at any given point, right? I have to go along to get along. No. You don't ever go along, even if it's the sacrificing the get along.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, and if even if it's the extent of, well, you know, everybody clocks in, you know, a half an hour early. I don't. You know, everybody takes an hour and a half lunch. It's totally cool. I'm not going to.
Right.
You know, it's that kind of passiveness to say, well, it's okay here. Like, all you're doing is getting in cahoots with a band of brigands. Right. All you're saying is I'm willing to sacrifice this so that I can be well liked or acknowledged by people other than God. And so the question is, who is your authority? You know, are you choosing to say, my authority is going to be the guy who will let everything slide, who has no real stance, who has no real authority, no real line of which what is morally good and morally bad. All I'm saying is that I'm willing to do that so he likes me. And it's a principled thing, and I think sometimes we have a problem with laying it out there and saying, look, who do I really serve? That's why I really like the phrase, is God on his throne or in Israel? Because frankly, if God is not on his throne, if God is not who he says he is, and he's not on his throne, my life looks way different, right? I take 3 hours worth of lunch. What do I care?
Right. They're not going to fire me. Everyone does it. That's fine.
Whatever you can get away with.
Yeah, exactly. There's no moral standard on that. But if God is who he says he is, and God is on the throne, my life has to look differently, or I'm frankly acknowledging truth and lying with my life. And the thing is it's nice to make a big stance like that, but the truth probably is that I'm lying in little bits every day, right? My life reflects a lie in a little bit every day, and it reflects a lie that God is not on his throne.
No, the Lord ain't back yet. Keep waiting.